Hello, welcome to Analytics in 15. Today's session is Build Real-Time Vision and Video-Enabled Applications. My name is David Malone. I'm a Specialist Solutions Architect here at AWS. Today, we are going to provide a quick overview of a service that you may or may not heard of before called Amazon Kinesis Video Streams. We will explain how to use it to stream media from your camera devices to the cloud, how to playback your media, and then how to use features in Amazon Kinesis Video Streams to build analytic solutions. And then we'll talk about some next steps as well. To begin with, we'll answer the quick question here. What is Kinesis Video Streams? Kinesis Video Streams is a streaming video service that was designed to make it easy to securely ingest media from camera devices to the cloud and do so scalably. What I mean by that is this service was designed to allow you to scale from millions of camera devices with easy-to-use SDKs and APIs to allow you to store, consume, and extract your media once it's in the cloud. So what does that look like? To begin with, Kinesis Video Streams provides a number of SDKs. Here you'll see that depicted as the Kinesis Video Streams Producer SDK. That comes with a few knobs and dials that allow you to control the configuration of how it transmits media from your camera devices to the cloud. For example, one thing you can control is the rate at which media fragments are transmitted via our HTTPS APIs to Kinesis Video Streams. You can kind of adjust that knob and that dial to stream between 1 and 10 seconds. When you create your stream in Kinesis Video Streams, you have the option to configure it to encrypt your media either with an Amazon managed key or a key that you provide through the key management service. We call those CMKs, or customer managed keys. On a stream-by-stream basis, you have the ability to set these encryption and retention settings. Retention is something that you can use to control how long media is stored in Kinesis Video Streams, and the range of valid values for that setting is between 0 hours all the way up to 7 years of storage. And then, finally, just like most other AWS services, if not all, access to the service itself, including how to obtain media once it's stored in Kinesis Video Streams, is controlled through AWS identity and access management policies. And this includes how can I provide the media for playback through my web or mobile applications, for example. And just at a really high level, when we think about a stream is very commonly one-to-one with camera devices. So per camera, I would think about having one named stream with its own configured retention and encryption, and then the resource of the stream is controlled through AWS IAM policies through regular AWS resource numbers, or ARNs for short. To get started, you can find all of our producer SDKs available in the languages listed here out on GitHub. These short links are available for convenience. Customers typically think about cloning these repositories and building them onto camera devices so that they can stream media from their cameras to the cloud, or to use in gateway devices that are deployed typically on-premises to obtain media from network cameras such as IP cameras over network protocols, including RTSP or ONVIF or other networking protocols. Kinesis Video Streams also provides a GStreamer plugin, and GStreamer is an open source framework not provided by AWS, but Kinesis Video Streams provides this to customers because it's a common way for customers to build media pipelines to obtain video and or audio data from existing cameras and to then make it easy to stream to Kinesis video streams. Once your data is being ingested or streamed into Kinesis video streams, there's a number of ways to play back or consume that media. What's pictured here is one of our sample applications that's available on GitHub that shows you how to play back the media as it's been stored in Kinesis video streams. Ultimately, you have the ability to build custom applications using our easy-to-use APIs, and there's a number of examples available on GitHub that can help you get started with this. Aside from playback, there's a number of options to extract your media, and then you can use other well-known AWS services to analyze the media. Options to extract media include APIs to automatically extract clips in an MP4 format for download and playback. Otherwise, you can perform a live or on-demand playback via HLS or Dash protocols. And both of those operations are easy-to-use APIs that Kinesis Video Streams provides for your media. For playback via HLS and Dash, you have the ability to play in different modes. One is just simply to play back the media live as the fragments are streaming into Kinesis Video Streams, and to play back a live stream in an HLS or Dash video player. Maybe in the web using libraries such as Video.js and things like that. You also have the ability to specify a time period in which to begin playback. And so that is going to be dependent on how long you have stored your media for based on the previously mentioned configurable retention period. So if you store your video for a given camera for up to a week and you wanted to go back last week, beginning of the week, and play back something that occurred at, say, 5 o'clock in the morning, as long as that timestamp is available within your retention period, you have the ability to go and play that media back to serve up an HLS or Dash URL to then begin playing back that media from that point. Otherwise, Kinesis Video Streams provides a number of APIs that also allow you to build custom media processing applications in a low latency fashion. And one of the components that Kinesis Video Streams provides for that is a consumer library that we call the Kinesis Video Streams Parser Library. The Parser Library works at a lower level of the APIs than the other APIs that were mentioned before and deals at the fragment layer. However, it allows you to consume fragments in a real-time fashion as soon as they are processed and passed through the Kinesis Video Stream service, or again, playback media that was stored or retrieve media that was stored previously, as long as it's within the configurable retention period. Within the Streams Parser Library, there's also options to automatically extract the media, decode it based on the various codecs that are possibly being used for your media, and to then build custom video processing applications with the media as it's flowing through your custom application. For the Kinesis Video Streams Parser Library, you may choose to run that on something like Amazon Fargate or Amazon Elastic Cloud Compute, for example, an EC2 instance. There is also a feature, which I will go into more detail about in just a moment, that allows you to automatically extract stills from your live video stream to an Amazon S3 bucket of your choosing. And that allows you to then integrate with other AWS machine learning services, such as Amazon Recognition Images, to perform automatic computer vision algorithms, such as face detection or other object recognition. Other options to analyze your media include a direct integration with Amazon Recognition Video through a feature called Streaming Video Events, or SVE for short. Amazon Recognition Video's Streaming Video Events service provides automated person, pet, and package detection, allowing customers to build connected home solutions such as smart doorbells to automatically detect when packages were delivered, when a pet is wandering by, just in case someone is looking for a missing pet, or when a person has approached, say, your front door. Otherwise, you can either use our custom APIs to extract media and build your own custom machine learning models through Amazon SageMaker, and then you can host those models as well in Amazon SageMaker and use that for custom machine learning inference as part of your media processing workflows. To provide a little more detail around how automated image generation works, the Kinesis Video Streams Producer SDK makes use of something called tags in the media that is streamed into Kinesis Video Streams. This is an important detail to understand because if you're attempting to use Kinesis Video Streams and some of the sample applications that don't support tags, then this particular feature would not work for you. There's a number of sample applications that the Kinesis Video Streams Producer SDK for C++ provides that makes this very easy to get started with. But the way this works is once a camera device is configured to stream its media to Kinesis Video Streams, then a customer operator persona depicted here in the top left would configure what we call image generation configuration on a named stream, and that would indicate to the Kinesis Video Stream service that it should automatically generate still images for that tagged media and to send that to an Amazon S3 bucket that you own. From there, once the images land in that S3 bucket, you have the opportunity to either integrate with some of the previously mentioned services, Amazon SageMaker, Amazon Recognition. You could work with your own custom AI or ML applications, or you could create a trigger through AWS Lambda from your Amazon S3 bucket to perform any sort of custom processing that you could think of in that workflow. In general, Amazon Kinesis Video Streams automated image generation allows you to configure a few things to control the output of these images that are generated through its transcoding server. It allows you to select the frequency at which the images are generated, and it also allows you to configure the type of image that's generated, either a JPEG image or a PNG image, and whether or not to downscale that image through width and height resolution settings as the image is extracted from your video data. This concludes our snackable 15-minute overview of how you can use Amazon Kinesis Video Streams to get started with your media data in the cloud to analyze it and to perform computer vision or other machine learning tasks on your media data in your applications. To learn more, a few links are listed here, including a hands-on workshop to get started with Kinesis Video Streams and a link to the developer guides. Thank you.